right, Gene, thank you very much. We look forward to your hotline report all the way up until midnight tonight, only on the WCW Wrestling Hotline. Still to come, we're going to show you the beating that Sting took at the hands of the New World Order and the gigantic announcement they made that Bret Hart would soon be joining the ranks of the New World Order. You heard me right. You know, we talked about it last Saturday that maybe it was just a rumor. But the rumor became a reality Monday when they announced Bret Hart would join the New World Order.
Do you believe that's the reality at this point? Have you seen him, talked to him, spoken to him about
that New World Order? No, I haven't,
thing?
But I money talks.
Oh, yeah.
They.
Yeah. One thing Eric Bischoff said, I love spending billionaire's money. You know what I mean? Well, money has really helped him get into power. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
And Bret Hart, being the athlete that he is, money's done stranger things to men, so, but I still got to see it. Rumors are rumors until they ain't rumors any longer.
One of the newcomers in WCW out of the West Indies, Norman Smiley, here in the ring. And
Norman comes to us with a great amateur background.
Sure does.
Very versed in all the arts of karate, wrestling, high-risk maneuvers. Taking a look at somebody that really over in his country and his island over there is quite a major star. But can he go ahead and step up here on Saturday night on the mothership right here and get to the pay window when it's so important? This is showcase time. The star maker here on TBS. And Lane, you know, he wants to get there too.
Sure. Lenny Lane is a fine young athlete. Norman Smiley started out with a three-quarter Nelson into a front chancery, and we've been told that Norman likes to mat wrestle. That's his forte.
Well, I just... Now, did I document that really smooth at first, like I was a regular commentator, you know what I mean? I really went through all his background. I and Mike would be mad, proud of me, and then you come and stepped on me and say, well, now he went for a three-quarter Nelson. Well, it could have been a guard Nelson. I don't know. But
look,
I know
at that maneuver.
What was that?
Sent him over with a hip toss.
Very nice.
And put Lenny Lane down. Norman Smiley comes to us with an abundance of confidence in his abilities. But if you think about confidence... Yeah, that's important when you're going into World War III, but it takes more than that. It takes a lot of experience. It takes years of being in the ring to be successful, I would think, because you have to realize that anything can happen.
You know what I believe, Tony? I believe it's going to come down to the big guys. I believe Kevin Nash and the Giant will be instrumental in this World War III situation when these 60 men are involved in that battle royal. I really do, Tony. Don't you? You already spoke up about
the
cruiserweights and everything. They're going to be involved, you know, but I really believe it's going to be down to the big guys.
Yeah, the big guys usually are the favorites in these type of events. The Giant won it last year as a member of the NWO, and they're favorites for a number of reasons, the most being the fact that they are so big, they're hard to take out. But I would think this, that when that battle royal commences next Sunday, 60 men, the focus of the NWO will be on the Giant to get him out. They realize he won it last year, and I know Kevin Nash would love to win this thing to prove that he is the real big man.
Yeah,
so I would think as a unit, they would hunt for the Giant to try to take him out.
They won't have to hunt. He'll be right there in their face.
He'll be able to see it.
He's a man's man. He'll be right there. Yeah, they won't be missing him. Nice move right here. There, take a little bite out of that apron. He went right down on his nose right there. That wasn't a great finesse move. It wasn't nothing pretty, but it was very effective. He stunned Lane.
Lenny Lane trying to rebound now, sending Norman Smiley into the corner. Lane's going to try to bulldog him, and he did. Put him down, and Lenny Lane, slow to make
wrap
a cover.
Him up.
One, two. You know, that was a great move by Norman Smiley after the bulldog, knowing that Lane was wasting some time. He rolled near the ropes.
Yeah, so he could get close.
So he get close if he needed to put a foot on a rope here.
Springboard coming off the second rope. Way up high, go for the elbow, nobody home. Good matchup right here. I like these. I like young guys coming in here on Saturday night trying to get to that pay window, really taking a step forward here at WCW. Sting and Hogan, that's the deal to me. You go ahead and talk about everything else. That is a mega deal. Hollywood Hulk Hogan is Hollywood. He is the man. To beat the man, you got to be the man. I don't care. You know, they brought up that, too, if we watch this thing go along right here. Nice move. They brought up this, too, Tony, about Sting being in a movie and all this thing. It made him irate. Bischoff and Hollywood. Oh, nice move.
Forward roll, submission hold.
That submission, he's buckling him right there.
At that, look at the positioning of the legs.
Nice.
And just pulling on the legs of Lenny Lane. That could tear out a groin muscle in a moment.
I'm going to tell you what, that looked like my house on Thanksgiving.
Wow.
At the end of that turkey. Wow. That was a wow. Nice move right there. Nice victory for this young man. Real nice young man.
I saw what happened to you. You need my help. All you gotta do is ask.
Well, he's dishing it out, Sam. I'll help you.
I'll help Chris Adams. More on Saturday night after this.